guys, what's up, how you doing? So we just finished from the studio. We went to take pictures for Sophia's birthday. So after taking the pictures, we are headed to Lush Gardens. So Lush Gardens, I'll carry you guys along anyway, but Lush Gardens is a lush garden where you can go and hang out, you can have small events, you can take pictures. I think they're preparing for their, they call it photo booth something something or whatever. I'll just you guys later and I'll carry you guys along, okay? So you can go there and take pictures. I think you pay an entry fee, then you take pictures. They have different props and stands and, you know, areas where you can take, you know, beautiful pictures. So I'm hoping to take pictures there today with my kids. But aside that, they're going to have bouncy castle. They're going to have, it's just a fun day anyway. So I'm really excited to take my kids for it. I'm always saying Port Harcourt doesn't have nice things, doesn't have nice places. I'm happy to discover this place today. And I'm happy to, yeah, I'm always looking forward to take my kids too. Because every Sunday, sometimes on Saturdays and Sundays, I take them out. So I'm always looking for new places, exciting places to take them to. So I'm excited to go and check this one out and see if it's going to work for us. And if it works for us, we'll be going there more often, okay?
Hold up, I am on my way. I'm in motion. Let's go to the ocean. Yeah, let's go outside. We can hang out on the beach without freezing. Yeah, isn't that amazing? In Christmas times, we'll be chilling and having a good, good time. Doesn't matter if the snow is falling or the wind blows and the rain is pouring. It will always be Christmas in my heart. But this year I wanna hang out with my friends and family. Santa's coming to visit. No, he wouldn't miss this in Christmas times. Oh, and the sunset, it is just getting better on a blanket with the skyline painted in blue. Ooh, yeah, that's what we do. We'll be chilling and having a good, good time.
Santa's gonna come and join us in this song.
Guys, we are back now. Our enjoyment has to be cut short because Eva is not feeling fine. Wait, see her here. Wait, let me show you guys. So that's Eva. They're eating fruits. She's not feeling fine because she's she's having tummy pain, you know, temperature. So we went straight to the hospital from there. They checked her. Amarachi too hasn't been feeling too well, so I just had to take the both of them to the hospital. They checked her and they checked Eva. Just bring the whole pack. Anything she wants to eat, let her eat it very well. Do you get? Anything she likes, let her eat it very well. What was that?
Kaora, thank Jesus.
Jesus, blood.
She's not feeling fine now.
Yeah, I'm playing my own grapes if you finish.
I'll buy for another day. I'll buy another day, but she's not feeling fine. So anything she likes, let her eat it very well. Anyway, so yeah, they were prescribed medication. So hopefully everything, you know, subsides today. Yeah, I'm sure they'll be fine, Sha. I'm sure this is just normal occurrence, okay? Normal weather change and stuff like that. Anyway, now that we're back to reality, let me quickly arrange this my office because I left in a hurry. Oh, first of all, I need to publish a video before I arrange everywhere and just make hair clean. Then I'll go and sleep because I've not really slept well in the past few days. I've been all over the place. Yeah, so see this one. Is you. It's you that I created office for. Yeah, Sophia. It's you that I made office for. See my mates in every way. Kora, pick up your shoes quickly. Pick up the shoes quickly. See. Sophia. Sophia, put it back. Bye.
Bye.
Bye, Sophia.
Bye.
No, no, no. It's Rabina, honey. There's no more. You can't take more than 1 meter.
Just one.
If I just take now.
I don't want to be naked. Should I drink it?
There's one inside. So I don't want that. I want her to drink that honey.
And
if that honey is inside, I don't want her to drink it. Okay.
Yeah. Let's not waste this sweet honey. Let me taste it again. But I'm tasting it. If I look at.
Guys, I finished clearing this place. Yeah, so when my mates were buying Christmas, you know, matching Christmas pajamas, I was doing eyes like I did not know what was going on. I was doing eyes like I did not see where my mates used to buy, you know, Christmas pajamas. I have no valid excuse for not buying it. It's just that it's expensive and I just didn't make up my mind on time to buy it. So I decided to go thrift shopping for it, basically for my kids and not even for myself. I wanted them to have, like, you know, cute Christmas pajamas. So I got from Second Edition Thrifts on Instagram. Okay, I think I showed it. If you're following me on Instagram, you would have seen where I posted it. So please, if you're not following me on Instagram, please, now is the time to follow your girl on Instagram, please, thank you. It is at Adaeze space. So when I bought those ones from Second Edition Thrift, I posted them because they were really nice. They're going to, you guys will see when they wear it anyway. So I now saw another page. It's called, I think it was Second Edition Thrift that I even posted it also. I can't remember how I came across this page. I feel like I'm not talking well. Anyway, so I just received the package from them. This one was, I now bought for myself, even though I really couldn't find my size. I bought size 14 to 16 and I'm actually a 16 to 18. So, no, I think I bought 16 to 18 when I'm actually 18 to 20 or something like that. Ooh, this is a gift she put inside. Wow, that's really nice. The name of this page is Posh 90s, okay? Posh 90s. She has really, really nice 90s. Yeah, she has really nice 90s. So, like normal regular 90s, she has a lot of really nice ones. So, I was just waiting for when I'll see like Christmas ones. So, yeah, look at the gift she put inside. I absolutely love this. Ooh, I'll use this to pack all my makeup when I want to travel. Yeah, nice. Thank you. Oh, and it fits my outfit somehow. It fits my outfit. So, that is it. So, this is the pack the 90s came in. Oh, there's even another one inside. Wow, so two. What? That is so amazing. Anyway, so this is M&S and they're quite affordable. It's thrift anyway. So yeah, so this is the nightwear. These are the trousers. Yeah, so this is the nightwear that I got. This is a Christmas nightwear. Ooh, I like the fabric. It's very, very soft. Ah, fantastic. Yes, this one is my size. Ooh, that's my Christmas nightwear. I like it. And this is the trousers. This would definitely enter me. Like this one be my size. Anyway, that's just what I wanted to show you guys this night. Let me just go and wash my face. Let me go and peel off my face first. Wash my face and I'll see you guys tomorrow morning, okay? Hi guys, good morning. This fan that is here will be making noise. You guys, see my eyes are red and swollen because I've not had enough sleep. I had to wake up like 200 times to be checking on Ava. And thank God I was checking on her because at night I saw her shivering, like literally shivering. So I had to give her paracetamol in the middle of the night. I had to give her early this morning as well. But she's doing better. You know, most times with kids, it gets worse at night. So she's doing better now. She's taking paracetamol, she's taking antibiotics, taking malaria medicine. Even though they didn't test for malaria, so I'm wondering why they're giving her malaria medicine. But anyway, I'll join. Yeah, I just wanted to quickly talk about something. It has been bothering me for a while. And personally, anytime I hear any news, okay, about children or things that have to... Basically, anytime I hear any sad news that, especially when it comes to children, you know, vulnerable women, vulnerable people in our society, not just children, vulnerable people in our society, I feel very unsettled, like, it bothers me so much. I try to even block it out, try not to talk too much about it, try not to even post anything about it. But most times, it's really hard for me to switch off because I tend to dwell on these things. Yeah, I tend to dwell, like things get, anyway. Yeah, so this one is about Sylvester, the boy that was beaten, you know, in school and subsequently died from the injuries he sustained from that beating. He was beaten by senior students. This story really, it really bothers me because I'm like, imagine your child going to school and being beaten to death by other students. Imagine, I saw videos, I tried not to watch, but I saw videos of the guy in pain. Like, I couldn't watch it, but at the same time, I wanted to see what was happening. The boy was in so much pain. Funny enough, physically, like, outwardly, aside bruises on his lips, they gave him something to drink that, you know, might have been poison. They gave him a chemical to drink. You know, aside the injuries on his lips and some here and there, he didn't really have so many physical bruises, but you could tell that this boy was in so much pain, like internally things were just not right. So anyway, I think one of my biggest takeaways from this is I'm not taking my kids to boarding school. I'm sorry, I've always not wanted to take them to boarding school. I've done a story time here about how people can be evil, especially children. In fact, I have so many stories to tell to buttress this fact. So because of it, thankfully, I didn't even start boarding school from JS1. I started from JS3 summer. Okay, we had this summer something in school that, what am I calling summer? NECO, okay, I forgot what they do, Isha, but in JS3, after JS3, students stay in school to prepare for exams or whatever. Anyway, so that's when I started, you know, that's when I became a boarder. And even at that time, I was dealt with, they dealt with me, seniors finished me, like, looking back now, I'm like, why did I have to go through those things? Imagine a child that is in school, maybe these are part of the reasons why we didn't even do so well in school then, because I did well, like, I was okay, at least I passed, I was an average student, let me just say, maybe a little above average, but I wasn't like the best student or anything in my class, but I was a little bit, maybe a little above average. But imagine what I could have been if I wasn't going through some of the things I was going through, especially when I was in boarding, you know, washing clothes for seniors. I'll wash my own, I'll wash clothes for seniors, I'll go and fetch water. I was making hair for seniors every weekend, like from Friday to Sunday night. I was, in fact, sometimes Monday morning, they'll call me, this one, come on, you know, make this hair fast. I was making hair for seniors. It got so bad that I even had to go and write a note. I've told you guys about it. I even called my mom. My mom came to school and then, hey, trust my mom now, you know. Children can be really evil. So imagine what students, you are saying you are putting your child in boarding school to learn independence and blah, 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 blah. For me, it doesn't count. Are you saying that all the children that don't go to boarding school don't learn independence? That's what I'm trying to say. What independence exactly are they going to learn? You learn it in university. You learn it in my house, okay? I'm going to structure my house in such a way that it will feel like boarding school.
So everybody has their own beds, has their own corners, have their own, no, I wouldn't say have their own room, but that might not be feasible because I have three girls. So at some point, two of them are going to have to share a room, then one will stay separate. Or maybe they will have one room if, you know, we hammer the hammer we're about to hammer, okay? Anyway, but everybody's going to have their own corner, have their own things, make their own breakfast, you know, get ready for school by themselves. Like, every single thing that they need to do, as when they're old enough to do these things, any single thing they need to do for themselves, I'll allow them to do it for themselves. And I'm going to have like a timetable, so when you come back from school, you know, we have time for prep, we have afternoon prep, you have evening prep, you know, you have dinner time, lunch time, you have activity time, you know, the time to go for sports, time to go for play, time to, aside the ones you do in school at home too as well. It's not going to be just, God help me, Sha, because all these things are easier said than done. When it is that time now, all of us will start doing like we don't know what's happening. But I'm just saying that is a better way, or that's a very good way of making your children independent. Of course, I know that not all parents can have their kids at home at that age because of their jobs and stuff like that. But you chose to have these kids, number one. Number two, if they kill your child, you will now know that you could have kept your child at home, okay? I'm not trying to blame Sylvester's parents in this case, not at all. It's far from it, because this thing could have happened to even me, that my parents put me in school at a much older age. It could have happened to me, okay? When I was in school, there were times when teachers came, senior students came and beat my mates. When I say beat, they beat the hell. They were breaking T-square on students' backs. They were throwing iron buckets at us. They were telling children, these were girls. They'll tell girls to walk inside gutter and they'll be weighing inside the gutter. And they'll tell, what am I saying? Walk. Crawl inside gutter, they'll weigh inside the gutter. They were telling girls to crawl on gravel, you know, other girls. So it's not even about, oh, boys and men and this. It's everybody equally. Boys and girls, you don't know where they're coming from, you don't know the homes they're coming from, you don't know how their parents raised them. Anyway, I don't want to go too much into this because this is not what this video is supposed to be about. Vlogmas is supposed to be cheerful and happy, and I want to stick to that, but I just have to say this, okay? I pray that, you know, all those people that were involved in this boy's case, both parents, so teachers, so as staff, admin, whatever, anybody that knew about it and helped to cover it up, I pray that they'll be brought to justice. Of course, that's too much to ask for the country that we live in, but hopefully, somehow, I heard that two of them were flying out of the country. If you like, fly out of the earth. If you like, fly to Mars. Fly to, you know, the moon, okay? Justice will be served. Karma will still meet you there, okay? The things you did, we are going to catch up with you. No matter how many years it takes, no matter how long it takes, the things you did are going to catch up with you one way or the other, okay? So you better come and face it now than wait till your future. When your future is supposed to be brighter, you'll not be facing those things, okay? So, another thing I wanted to say is that what is even shocking to me the most is how silent parents of the school are. Parents that have their kids in that school. Other parents, I don't mean the parents involved now. I mean just regular other parents that have their kids in that school. I heard that they said some people were having online classes instead or whatever. Why would my child still be having anything to do with a school where a boy's murder was covered up? Because, yeah, he was murdered. He was murdered, not even manslaughter or whatever. Like, they wanted to kill him. That's just the truth. Because you can't tell me nothing. They wanted to kill him. Why would you give him a substance to drink? Why would you beat him that much because of what? He didn't join court or whatever. Anyway, so why would I want my children to be attending such a school, whether remotely or physically? Why? That does not make any sense whatsoever. It could have happened to my child, knowing that my child was in that same school. I can just, I don't know. Anyway, I've said this before. Anytime anything happens, you know, around children, about children, even if they are older children, I picture my children in that situation. Oh, God forbid. It's not my portion. But it's not anybody's portion, basically. But it's not my portion, Sha. Anyway, all I'm trying to say is that the teachers, the school, the parents, whoever is involved in covering this thing up, people should better come out and talk. I don't know what they're covering up there. I don't know what the school is doing for you. I don't know what the school has on you or has on your kids that you are choosing to be silent. I don't even understand it, okay? Anyway, let me just end this video here because I'm really pissed. I'm really not in the mood. I'm about to film another video. You guys should watch out for my Q&A. I'm going to do a Q&A 10 years after marriage. So you guys ask me questions, so I'm going to be answering them right after this video, okay? That's tomorrow, okay? So stay tuned and I'll see you guys tomorrow. Bye, guys.